today because we know that our God will. Amen. I'm excited today. Amen. Let's give these children a hand. About what's going on here in Star. Amen. I'm thinking about trying to figure out how I can fit all of these young people in my Volkswagen. Take them back to Peacefield. Amen. They're on fire for the Lord. Amen. They're on fire. Amen. We thank God for the fire that is in here. Amen. I feel God's presence in here. I was hoping the pastor told me that I could preach 15 minutes ago, amen, because the Spirit is just moving. How do you feel the Spirit of the Lord in here? I feel the Lord in here, and I believe God is up to something. Just touch your neighbor and say, I believe God is up to something. I believe God is up to something. I believe something's about to happen.
Chapter, I'm reading from the Life Application Bible, NIV, and it reads as
such, so you must remain faithful to what you have been taught from the beginning. Listen to this embracing ministry. If you do not, you will remain in fellowship with the Son. If you do, you will remain in fellowship with the Son and with the Father. And this fellowship, we enjoy the eternal life He has promised us. I am writing these things to warn you about those who want to lead you astray. But you, somebody shout, but you. But you have received the Holy Ghost, and He lives within you. So you don't need anyone to teach you what is true. For the Spirit teaches you everything you need to know, and what He teaches is true. Oh God, it is not a lie. So just as He has taught you, remain in fellowship with Christ. And now, dear children, remain in fellowship with Christ so that when He returns, hallelujah, touch a man and tell him He's about to return, you will be full of courage and not shrink back from Him in shame. Since we know that Christ is righteous, we also know that all who do what is right are God's children. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let us pray. Father, we thank You in advance for what You're about to do, oh God. God, I feel Your anointing in this place. Let me move in Your anointing. Let me operate in the gift that You have given me. Let me not be afraid of the faces of the people, but let me preach under Your anointing, God. Spirit of the living God, pour on Your servant that I may pour out into Your people. I claim it in the name of Jesus, for I must never forget that the wickedness, the evil, the unclean spirits that we are fighting are not just in our homes, not just in the street, not just in our jobs, but they're in the church. They're in the church only because we, the believers of God, are not equipped to rebuke the enemy. We come to church, we come to hear a word from God, we leave excited, but we do not have the power of the Holy Ghost to rebuke the unclean spirits that are in the atmosphere. Some of us come to church with an attitude. Some of us come to church angry. Some of us even preach mad. Some of us pray with an attitude. Not because somebody did something to you, because you've been dealing with spirits and you could not discern the spirit that you were dealing with. Some of us don't realize you got the spirit from the last place you left. It was there before you got there, but you couldn't discern it. So that spirit connected to you, and you brought the spirit into your house. You brought that spirit into your job. Now you brought that spirit into your house, and now you're mad at the pastor because he has to preach through those unclean spirits. You're mad at the choir because they gotta sing through those unclean spirits. The deacons gotta pray through those unclean spirits, but the spirits got here nothing when I can. Only because the word of God that is going forth is not going forth in a way with power that can break the yokes in the house. The prayers that are going forth are not going forth in the power of God so that it can break yoke. When we embrace those that we don't know, it doesn't embrace it with the power of the Holy Ghost that we can break those spirits so that
preaching,
or the woman of God is preaching, when the deacon is praying, spirit, when we have the gift of the discerning spirit, we don't have to wait to see who the devil is, because those of us that have the gift of the spirit, the devil knows us before we come into the house. I feel like preaching now, and if some of us would realize what's inside of you, the devil's afraid of you, and he gets mad when you come to church, because when you come to church, things begin to happen in the atmosphere. Can I preach like I feel this morning? Some of us don't realize the power that dwells up in us. That when you sit on the pew, everybody on the pew is blessed because of you. Hallelujah. Some of us don't realize that when you come into the sanctuary, demons got to move because of the anointing that is on your life. And so he teaches John here. He teaches in the spirit of love. He teaches that in love we have this divine spirit, but in love we have this divine spirit, but we have a spirit of discernment. And he teaches us so that we would be able to recognize those all that are in God and those that are not in God. Watch this. See, when I told you earlier, that's why we gotta make sure that whoever you got guarding the door has a discerning spirit that can discern who's of God and not of God before they come into the church. Because there's some people, you got to tell them, you can't come here. I know this church is for everybody, but you got a spirit. So he teaches them so that they would understand the distinction between those that live their lives in darkness and those that live their lives in the light. Why does he teach them? He teaches them this because in Jude prepares us for the antichrists that are already here and the antichrist that is coming. He prepares because he wants them to be able to discern the antichrists that have slipped in the church and the antichrists that slipped in your house, and understand that you have this divine power to defeat this antichrist that has slipped in your house. Hallelujah, Jesus. And the Bible says here, he teaches them, he says that you can continue to have this power because this power was in you. Spirit, but you don't know what to do with this spirit because your spirit is always embracing people and with a smile on your face, but they won't smile back at you. But God says, remain faithful. Sometimes you're going to pray over people that will curse you right to your face, but God says, remain faithful. Sometimes you're going to preach to people that don't want to hear what you got to say, but God says, remain faithful. God says, remain faithful, because God is soon to come. Watch the text. Watch this. He says, don't remain faithful, as he says in Luke 10, because you have the power. But remain faithful because your name is written. Come on, somebody. He says, remain faithful because Jesus is soon to come. And when Jesus comes, he gonna see your name written in the Lamb book of life. He says, remain faithful because I have given you a power to stay faithful. I like that. Touch your neighbor and tell them, stay faithful. Don't be a Christian today and be unsaved tomorrow. Don't praise. God has given you a spirit to remain faithful even until the end. Even if the world doesn't be faithful, I have a spirit in me that's making me faithful even when I can't be faithful. There's a spirit in me that keeps me grounded and rooted in the Lord even when the enemy is coming at me from every side and pushes me on every side. But when it pushes me, it can't knock me down.
Play!
praising him now before I get the blessing. Because when the blessing comes, I'm going to really lose my mind. Do I got a witness in the building today? John says, watch this. Peter has to minister to broken people, and he's telling them in their brokenness that you have this power. They've lost their homes. They're running because the government's chasing them, because they're doing things in the name of Jesus. And so Peter has to preach to these broken people, and it's helping them understand that where you are is temporary.
Yeah.
Touch your neighbor, tell them this is temporary. He's teaching them because he wants them to understand they're in a temporary place. Then John comes along and say, in your temporary place, you got to love these people that treat you wrong. Until Jesus comes, I got to deal with this person that don't like me. Can't cuss them out. I can't snap my neck. I got to stand on the word of God and smile.
You can hear the spirit.
to remain faithful. You have this power, the power to keep you anchored. And I have given you a discerning spirit. And with this discerning spirit, your job is to discern it, not to fight it. I'm going to end right there. Touch your neighbor and say, don't fight that. That's your job. Your job is to discern it. Somebody else's job is to fight it. Somebody else's job is to pray for it. That's why he gives us gifts in the house so that we can utilize the spiritual gifts of God. The problem is we try to do everything, but God didn't call you to do that. God said to serve it. I already equipped somebody to fight it. Watch this, and I'm done. Peter's job was to recognize it. It was John's job to impart it. It was Jude's job to fight it. And in Revelation, God reveals it. Y'all missed that. There are some things that we will discern that God will not reveal to you. Touch your neighbor and say, that ain't your business. Your job is to recognize it's unclean. Your job is to recognize that it ain't for you. And know that you have the power to stand and remain faithful to God. Come on, put the hands together. Come on, put the hands together.